answer. This is the lecture number 5. Again, I am just telling you that if you want to just know this lecture, you must go in the previous lecture, then it will be clear. Okay. So, today we are just taking the rabies test. What is rabies test? What they have written us? Let sigma u and b n infinite series and limit n tends to infinite n into un upon un plus 1 minus 1 is equal to lambda. Then, if lambda is greater than 1 converge, lambda is less than 1 diverge, lambda is equal to 1 fail. Okay. You must note that here the ratio test, it is just opposite un upon un plus 1, not un plus 1 upon un. Okay. So these are all values also opposite. Before it was lambda is less than 1, then converge. But here lambda is greater than 1, then this is converge. Now the question is how to find that we have to use the rabies test. Okay. Just check here. This time you have x to the power 2n. So whenever you have any variable with this series, then you will use such type of rabies test or another logarithmic test and other test. Okay. You will use. So this time the clue is this. Okay. So at first we will use the previous method. Go to the previous lecture again. I am just explaining you. Okay. Now you can see that at first I will fail the previous lecture. Okay. So you can see that there is a factorial. So whenever you have factorial, then you have to use the ratio test. Okay. So you have un is equal to n factorial square upon 2n factorial x to the power 2n. Okay. So what about un plus 1? Un plus 1 is equal to n plus 1 factorial square upon, this is square, and 2 n plus 2 actually, 2n plus 2 factorial x to the power 2n plus 2. Okay. After then you have to divide un plus 1 upon un. Okay. So un plus 1 upon un. Okay. Then you will get this is n plus 1 factorial whole square. So in this condition you can write, okay, that is same now. So you have n plus 1 factorial, that is square, and after then you are getting 2n plus 2, then you are getting 2n plus 1, then you are getting 2n factorial. Okay. And this value you can write 2n into x to the power 2. Okay. Into upon un, just opposite. Then you are getting 2n factorial. Okay. So after then 2n factorial, then you are getting upon n factorial whole square, then x to the power 2n. Okay. This is here x to the power 2n. Okay. This value, you can also solve it. This value, n plus 1. Actually, what is this? This n plus 1 factorial, you can write n plus 1 into n factorial. You can write, okay. So, you can write this n plus 1 into n factorial. Okay. Then, your value, now you can cancel it. This cancel, then after then this cancel, this cancel. And this n factorial whole square, n factorial whole square, this and this cancel, then at last you will get limit n tends to infinite u n plus 1 upon u n is equal to, you are getting n plus 1 whole square, this value, okay, upon this value 2 n plus 2 into 2n plus 1, okay, and also you have x square, okay. So now if you will take n square common, then you are getting limit n tends to infinite 1 plus 1 upon n whole square upon 2 plus 2 upon n, and this is 2 plus 1 upon n into x square. Limit n tends to infinite 0, n tends to infinite 0, n tends to infinite 0. And you are getting, this is 2 to the 4, x square upon 4, okay. According to the, this is ratio test. According to the ratio test, if x square upon 4, go to the previous lecture, if x square upon 4 is less than 1, if x square upon 4 is greater than 1, if x square upon 4 is equal to 1. For this condition fail, but for this condition and for this condition, that is convergent and that is divergent. Okay, that is okay, no problem. The problem is this: whenever you have x square is equal to 4, then this is fail. So your ratio test fail. Whenever your ratio test fail, then you will use the Revish test. Okay. Whenever your ratio test is failed, then you will use the Revish test. Okay. I am erasing it. Okay, some portion. I am using this formula to find. Whenever you are taking x square is equal to 4, then what will happen? Already we have done something. This we have done. If x square upon 4 is less than 1, then convergent. If x square upon 4 is greater than 1, divergence. If x square upon 4 is equal to 1, then fail. Okay. Let we are taking x square is equal to 4. Then what will happen? We will check for Revish test. Okay. I am erasing it. So, according to this, we have limit n tends to infinite n into un upon un plus 1 minus 1. Now we will check where it will go. So you have this, okay, un upon un plus 1. Already this value, it is un plus 1 upon un. Okay, so I am just reversing it. So this is n, okay. Then this is un upon un plus 1. Solve it. The previous value, it was un plus 1 upon un. It was n square plus 1 upon 2n plus 2. Okay. N plus 1 whole square. Okay. And it was 2n plus 1 into x square. It was, the value was this. So I am just putting above, then after then 2n plus 2, okay, this is 2n plus 1 upon n plus 1 whole square into x square. In place of x square, I am putting 4, okay, in place of x square, I am putting 4, so the 4 will come here and minus 1, okay, so now you have to solve it. In this condition, you have to solve it. So now you can see also, if I am just taking outside 2, this is limit n tends to infinite. Limit n tends to infinite, okay. This is n outside, okay. I am taking 2 outside. Then after then, you can see that there is n plus 1 already. 2n plus 1 already, there is n plus 1 whole square, okay. N plus 1 and into 4, okay. 2 to ja. 4, okay, then after then this cancel, so you are getting limit n tends to infinite n into, you are getting this cancel, then you are getting 2n plus 1 upon here 2 into n plus 1 minus 1. Okay, now solve it, then you are getting n tends to infinite n 2n plus 1 minus 2n minus 2n minus 2 minus 2 upon 2 into n plus 1. Okay, so you can see that both cancel, 1 minus 2 is equal to minus 1. So in this condition, your value is limit n tends to infinite, n is outside, okay, and your value is 1 minus 2 is equal to minus 1 upon 2n plus 1. Okay, so now again take the n common, then after then you will get limit n tends to infinite minus 1 upon 2, 1 plus 1 upon n. If n tends to infinite, then this is 0, then it is converging to minus 1 upon 2. Okay, and you know that minus 1 upon 2, that is less than 1, that is less than 1. Now you can see that if lambda is greater than 1, convergent. If lambda is less than 1, divergence. That is less than 1, divergence. Okay. If x square is equal to 4, then this is divergence. Okay. Then this is divergence. So, you know that in the ratio test, we concluded this one, but for x square upon 4 is equal to 1, the test was fail. Then after then we use this revised test, we put x square is equal to 4 in place of this. After then we solved and we got that if you are putting x square is equal to 4, then this series is divergence. So the overall conclusion, whenever x square is less than 4, then this is convergent. Okay, whenever x square is greater than 4, this is divergence, but equal to also. So for this is divergent, for this is convergent. So you have to answer this value in your exam. They will ask for what value this is convergent, for what value this is divergence. So the very simple question, at first you have to use the ratio test. Okay, then why you are using ratio test? Whenever you have factorial, then you will use the ratio test. Okay, and at first you have to use the ratio test, then after then you have to revise test. Revise test and ratio test, okay, both are same, only something we have changed. Whenever the ratio test fails, then you will use the revise test. To know the revise test, you must have x. Whenever you have x, and here is also n factorial. N factorial means you are using ratio test. You know that you are using ratio test. If there is a x, then it will fail. Okay, in which condition it will fail, you will check it, and for that condition you will put the value. Then after then you will use the revise test. Then after then you will get a conclusion. That conclusion you will put here, and that is the final result. Okay, I think that you understand. Pause the video, again watch it, then your concept it will clear. Thank you so much.